Hi, I'm Akhil. I'm from OnCourse, which is an education consulting company focused on study abroad opportunities. I myself was an international student from Mumbai who actually graduated from Northwestern in Chicago. Today we're going to discuss the various kinds of international school systems that we have here in India. There are actually three main kinds of international school systems that are available for 11th and 12th graders. The first kind is the IB, or the International Baccalaureate. The second is the A-levels. And the third is Advanced Placement, or the APs. The IB system is actually a very holistic system. It's a holistic form of education. It actually requires students to take three higher level subjects and three standard level subjects, one of which has to be a math, an English, a science, a humanity, and a foreign language. Over and above this, it's really important to understand, especially for students who are looking to apply for engineering, that their subject choice is really important. So they have to take math and physics at an HL, and they should also look to take chemistry either at an HL or an SL. Besides this, there's also focus on something called CAS, which is Creativity, Action and Service. For a student who's looking to pursue anything aside from engineering, their subject choice should really be based on their interest and their abilities. One really key thing to note is that your course rigor matters, and that should be considered when you're deciding what your subject choice. So the A-levels is actually a UK or a Cambridge board. It's actually scored anywhere between an A star to a G. It's actually broken up into two sections, one of which is the AS, which is taken in grade 11, and one of which is the A-levels, which is taken in grade 12. Now, most students take between 3 to 5 subjects in their AS or their grade 11, and eventually they narrow that down to 3 to 4 for their final A-level. Just to give you an understanding also, it's really important that for students who are looking to take science, that they take math and a physics or a chemistry all the way up to the A-levels. And for any student looking to apply abroad, they should definitely look to take English at least at an AS. Advanced Placement, of the APs, is actually a US-based education system where you actually get college-level courses that you do at the high school level. So in India, actually there are no schools which offer just the AP curriculum. AP has usually been included in curriculums over and above their normal, either Indian curriculum or the international curriculum. However, it's important to note that it's taken mostly by students from the Indian curriculum because it's an addition and it kind of adds the international flavor for those who are looking for a comparative analysis with their peers from international schools. The key aspect of an AP is that it's scored on 1 to 5, and if you score a 4 or 5, you get college credit when you go to college, which means that you save both time and money. I think it's really important to know that if you're going to take your AP curriculum over and above your regular school curriculum, your high school grades are still the most important criteria of admission. So it's not, doing really well in your APs is not going to compensate for poor school grades. And I think that's a really important point to note. All right, that's it for today. If you have any comments or feedback, please feel free to write to us on www.oncourseglobal.com. I look forward to hearing from you. And that's it for today. Bye.